In this video, Excel will be set up to solve equations by iterative calculations and goal seek. To clearly show how iterations work, let's change the calculation settings to manual so we can step through the process. So, go up to File, find Options, click Formulas. In the Calculation options, select Manual and make sure the Recalculate workbook before saving is unchecked. Next, we want to check the Enable Iterative Calculation box and set the maximum iterations to a value of 1. This worksheet is laid out to see how the iterative method works and how it converges to the solution. The objective is to find the value of x that is equal to the cosine of x. Remember that the units for x will be in radians, since Excel's cosine function requires x in radians. Before you begin calculations, let's review the cosine function. Recall that the cosine function cycles between negative 1 and positive 1. So, when you use successive approximation to calculate x is equal to the cosine of x, the solution will fall in the range from negative 1 to positive 1. Going back to Excel, we are ready to enter the equations. Although pi is not in the range of the cosine function, we will use that as an initial guess to demonstrate how the iterations converge on a solution. The on-off switch needs to initially be set to 0, which means that the iterations are turned off for now. The x value will be an if statement that checks if the switch is off. If the switch is off, x equals the initial guess. If the switch is on, or not 0, then x will equal the solution found below for cosine of x. The cosine of x cell will be set equal to the cosine function with the x value inserted. This creates a circular reference where x depends on the solution for cosine of x, but the cosine of x function looks at what x equals. That's why we changed the option settings earlier. The difference is simply the difference between the cosine of x and x. It shows how far apart the solution is for each iteration. The iterations will also be an if statement, and this cell will display the number of iterations Excel has performed. This allows us to reset iterations to 0 by setting the switch to 0 and pressing the F9 key on the keyboard. And the final cell is set equal to the iterations. This is where another circular reference appears. To begin, set the on-off switch to 1. To calculate, you can either press F9 or go under the Formulas tab and select Calculate Sheet. So, Excel took the initial guess of 3.14 and returned a value of negative 1. When you tell Excel to execute another iteration, it will take negative 1 as the initial guess and calculate a new cosine of x. As you can see, when negative 1 is used as an initial guess, the returned value is equal to 0.54. This calculation process continues for each iteration. Once Excel has gotten through 26 iterations, the values for x and cosine of x match up to the hundreds thousandths place. Since the two values are extremely close, it is safe to say that x is equal to cosine of x at 0.739. Although Excel is a very useful tool, it is important to be aware that limitations do exist. For example, we have been working with x is equal to the cosine of x. Algebra allows us to take the arccosine of both sides without changing the problem. This reduces to the arccosine of x equals x. Rearranging terms, we end up with x is equal to the arccosine of x. So x is equal to both the cosine of x and the arccosine of x. Therefore, we should be able to do the same iteration process to solve x is equal to the arc cosine of x and arrive at the same solution. Let's try. Use the same worksheet as before and change the cosine equation to arc cosine. Remember to change the on-off switch to 1 before calculating. Notice here that our initial guess is the solution from x equals the cosine of x. After one iteration, the x and the arc cosine of x values are relatively close to one another. Continuing on with the iterations, it can be seen that the values for x and arc cosine of x are diverging from one another. The values continue to diverge up until the point when an error occurs in Excel. This is why it is important to be aware that although Excel is useful in many situations, it does have limitations. Another useful tool in Excel is GoalSeek. This can be applied to find single unknowns with single constraints. Let's use GoalSeek to solve the same equation, x is equal to the cosine of x. Unlike before, the x value is no longer an if statement, so enter a 0 for now. The cosine of x is the same function as before. Simply insert x into the cosine function. The difference is also the same, with it being cosine of x minus x. Now you are ready to use GoalSeek. Under the Data tab, find What If Analysis and choose GoalSeek. Excel is now prompting you for the parameters. Since we want x and cosine of x to be equal, we want to set the difference between the two to a value of 0 by changing the x value. A circular reference warning will appear. Select OK. A dialog box pops up displaying the results. The values for x and cosine of x are very close to one another, and the difference between the two is very small. GoalSeek quickly solved this problem, which is why it is a good tool to understand how to apply. Let's take a look at another way this problem could be set up. Before, we started with x is equal to the cosine of x. If we rearrange those terms so that they are on the same side of the equals sign, we end up with x minus the cosine of x equals 0. The reason for doing this would be to allow us to not have to calculate the difference separately. So, first we will rename the worksheet and delete the difference cells. Here, we will reset the x value and change the equation in the cosine cell to match our new problem. With our worksheet set up, we can now use GoalSeek. So again, in the Data tab, under What If Analysis, choose GoalSeek. This time, set the x minus the cosine of x cell equal to a value of 0 by changing the x value. As you can see, Excel arrives at the same value as before, because remember, we didn't change the problem, we just condensed the difference calculation into the same cell as the cosine function. Now that you've used GoalSeek to solve x is equal to the cosine of x two different ways, let's see if it works for the arc cosine of x. Going back to the same worksheet, simply reset the x value and change the cosine function to the arc cosine function. Find What If Analysis and choose GoalSeek. Our parameters will be the same as before. We want to set x minus the arc cosine of x to a value of 0 by changing the x value. Select OK if a circular reference warning appears. So, unlike earlier, when using GoalSeek to solve the arc cosine of x, a solution is found. And remember to go back to File, Options, Formulas, change the calculation options back to automatic, and turn the iterations off. Excel will warn you that the current worksheet is using circular references. Select OK. This will ensure that the settings will be back to default the next time you need to use Excel. In conclusion, when using iterative calculations, you can either use successive approximations or you can take advantage of GoalSeek.